WCW No Holds Barred.
We're back from intermission, and as you can hear, we built this city on rock and roll. If you didn't know, here comes Tony Steffen. What does that t-shirt say?
It says CCW is pussy. Thanks.
Big facts. Steffen in his street fight gear.
Well, Steffen was originally scheduled to wrestle Eddie Kingston tonight, right?
That is 100% correct.
And I don't think that's happening.
That is not happening.
So who is he wrestling?
I believe that he will be standing across the squared circle from none other than Killer Kross.
Oh, well, I guess Tony Steffen is pretty fucked today.
Yeah.
So, everyone, as you know tonight, Chris Dickinson is not here.
The guy's in a fucking hospital. Give me a break.
What you also don't know is that Eddie Kingston was afraid to fight me tonight.
Oh, is that what it was?
So Eddie Kingston is not here tonight. So, whatever dumbass wants to come out and fight me, let's go, bitch, because I had a few beers in me, I just had a Sprite, and I'm ready to fight.
Well, the fans here at the White Eagle, oblivious to the fact that there was literally a change of the lineup.
Yep. Well, here comes a bad, bad man.
And a huge, huge man.
We're talking about one of the hottest free agents in the world of professional wrestling, Killer Kross.
Killer Kross made a name for himself this very building just about 8 months ago in a match against Davey Boy Smith Jr.
Oh boy, what a fucking match.
Opened a lot of eyes, turned a lot of heads. Kross didn't have the best 2019. He'll probably be the first to admit it. You know, sometimes the legalese gets in the way.
Of course, man,
but at the end of the day, what it comes down to is that where you're a professional athlete, you've got a limited amount of time to fight at your peak. And Kross is a free man right now, and he's going to be fighting at his peak. And if I was Tony Steffen, I probably would have taken a page out of Eddie Kingston's playbook,
and I
would have stayed home too.
Yeah,
we know, but not to make light of the situation, Eddie Kingston not cleared. He's getting his knee drained in Florida. He wasn't cleared to fly. And Chris Dickinson's laid up in a hospital bed right now.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the introduction, introducing first, standing to my left, fighting out of the sweetest place on earth, Hershey, Pennsylvania, this is Tony Steffen. And his opponent, standing to my right, fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in this evening at 265 pounds, this is Killer Kross!
Now, Struggles, let me just give you a little bit of backstory. Kross and Dickinson actually faced off just about a month ago.
That's correct.
An organization called FSW in Las Vegas. Dickinson was disqualified. And I know that Dickinson was very much looking forward to this matchup tonight. But unfortunately, Dickinson is laid up in a hospital bed in Staten Island. He's got pneumonia in both of his lungs.
Oh,
now you got to think that Dickinson, knowing that he was disqualified against Kross and that was not going to happen here tonight, was trying to gain an edge. Headed into No Holds Barred, Volume 1.
No DQs here.
No. only referee's decision of pinfall, but you also know that Killer Cross is coming into today with a totally different mindset, looking to avenge the actions of Chris Dickinson out in the West Coast, and instead it's Tony Deppen, who probably had a better 2019 than anybody else on the independent wrestling circuit, that's going to be paying for Dickinson's sins.
Can't argue that. We've seen a theme here on this show, a lot of people in street fighting clothes, but a professional fighter is in his gear, ready to go, Killer Cross, and I mean, what's the game plan?
Oh, the game plan is going to be a different,
annihilate.
No, it's a different dichotomy than what you're going to see. This guy's not going to rely on any sort of weapons,
no, sir.
Such as chairs, barbed wire doors. This man is a walking weapon.
He is the weapon.
He is the weapon. Don't get mad at me, Josh Alexander.
Big shot to the gut here. He's got the head hooked.
And you can tell Deppen, I mean, he's not even taking this match seriously. Look at what he's wearing. He's wearing Daisy Dukes, trying to make light of the fact that there's no rules. Definitely deviating from what he normally wears to the ring. But Deppen is scrappy. I will say
Speak
this about
that.
Killer Cross. There's probably, you can count on one hand the number of wrestlers that beat Nick Gage in 2019. Killer Cross is one of them. Killer Cross and Gage have unfinished business. That's a different story for a different day. But Tony Deppen is not going to let that momentum slow down heading into 2020, whereas Killer Cross is looking to build that momentum. I know momentum can be a bad word sometimes in professional wrestling, but Killer Cross cannot sell Deppen short.
Deppen with a knee strike. I don't think he got all of that because Cross right back up to his feet.
The size is going to be a difference throughout this entire contest. But Deppen knows what it's like to fight from underneath.
Yeah, he is definitely a specialist when it comes to that.
And Deppen, he's a hometown hero too. You can't sell him short on that.
Yep.
Capacity crowd here at the White Eagle. As Deppen, again, you not die. Able to build up ahead of steam by rebounding off the ropes. Instead, just going straight at it and like a missile getting launched out of a cannon. Wiping out Killer Cross.
Safety
on
first,
the floor.
In his shoes.
But that was valuable time he was eating up.
Big strikes from Deppen as the crowd opens up. Ooh,
and I was
boy.
Just going to say, what a stupid strategy out of Deppen.
Yeah.
You're not going to be able to go strike for strike with Killer Cross. About a foot taller, about 100 pounds heavier.
Got him in the headlock. Yes, punching him in the face.
Hashtag NHB1. No holds barred, volume 1.
Where are these guys going? Deppen's up on the bar.
And that's what you've got to do. That's what you've got to do. When you're giving up a foot and 100 pounds, you got to find something higher to jump off of.
Get creative, kid. Big dive off the bar. Cross looks staggered.
Deppen's favoring himself, too, though.
He is.
No count being issued by the official. We're not going to see a count out.
No,
this one isn't going to end in disqualification like the first contest between Cross and Dickinson. And you know if you're ICW, that's going to be the next match you're going to go to as soon as both athletes are cleared. Again, obviously, I want to wish Dickinson a speedy recovery. I mean, pneumonia in both the lungs is nothing to joke about. He wouldn't have missed this match for the world.
These two just barreling through the crowd. Up on the stage area.
Oh, getting dangerously close to us.
Yeah. We don't really have much room for movement.
No, but you can feel each one of these chops being this close. Literally reverberating through the halls here at the White Eagle Hall in Jersey City, New Jersey. But again, Deppen keeps making the same mistake as he gets laid out. Do not go strike for strike.
No way.
You need to evade it. You need to jump off of something higher. You're going to come a little bit harder.
Oh, boy.
And what did he say? He's going to bomb him into the ring?
Sounds like
it. Is that sending a message to Tony Deppen, or is that sending a message to the Dirty Daddy, Chris Dickinson?
I think we're going to have a loud and clear message.
Could have hooked up in that crucifix. Shades of a running Pazuzu bomb!
Oh!
Deppen landing on the bloodstained canvas. But Killer Cross, man, again, he's been looking to fight all 2019, now into 2020. Anytime.
Look at that scrappy Tony Deppen.
But anytime the crowd is in his favor, knowing that Deppen was the favorite, he's wasting time. He's letting that moment sink in because he's lacked those moments.
Absolutely. You hit the nail on the head there, Drew.
I mean, dude, let's be real. How many times has he wrestled in front of a crowd this big? Impact isn't drawn while ICW is drawn.
You speak no lies, DC.
Oh!
Big clothesline from Killer Cross.
Deppen getting up on instinct alone and getting mowed down at the hands of a killer, Killer Cross.
Man, Tony's not looking so hot.
Deadlift! A deadlift position! Belly down on the mat! Just manhandling Tony Deppen! And Levin checking to see if this might be the time to call the match off.
I mean, is he still with it, man? Let's see. Yes, he is. We talked about Deppen being the ultimate underdog, and he shows just that, getting his shoulder up.
You got to think that somebody like Cross's time on the indies is limited, too. We know back in April we had William Regal in here, we had Moxley in here.
They were very impressed with the showing. Dragon Screw leg whip to the floor and then hooks the head.
Look at how strong he is. One hand, Deppen back up to a vertical face. Deppen, I'll give him credit for how resourceful he is. These karate chops to the back of the neck. A little bit of step over misdirection.
Ooh,
and that was a knee to the temple. No, referee should be calling it off right now. Cross is out. Deppen should not have to be continuing the fight with his hammer blows.
You see the way he went limp? Those huge fucking elbows.
Well, this is definitive.
Oh, get the fuck out of here.
Not even a one count. It's going to be a long night for Tony Deppen.
Yeah. There's that knee again.
But I'm on the opposite temple that time. Leg is hooked. Much better lateral press. Still not enough to put Cross away.
Tony finding a way to string together some strikes to really rock Killer Cross. Those knee strikes seem to be working.
Deppen able to get all the way.
A little higher?
Yep. All the way. That's above the top rope, ladies and gentlemen. Off that platform, coming down with a crossbody. Plucked out of midair! Toss him around like it's a pizza!
Oh!
I don't want to eat that. But Tony Deppen just ate it.
The strength of Killer Cross.
Tony Deppen up in that military press position.
Oh, no. Cross that chain. Oh!
You can see him favoring the side of his face. Imagine that pressing up against your teeth. That's going to be loosening some molars all the way to the back of your mouth. Got him hooked by the trunks. Deppen nowhere to go. How can he escape this hole? He's just going to succumb. Oh, my God. In the leverage, it's almost like a pulling pile driver like you'd see from Mick Foley, but it's a Saito suplex.
Look at him roll with it, DC. Good God.
All right, ref. What's the ref seeing that I'm not? Deppen is lifeless.
Look at him. He's out!
You can tell Levin's conflicted here. I mean, a fourth Saito suplex.
Oh.
His arms are curled up. His body is limp. And that was the right call. But that would have been the right call two suplexes ago. I'll tell you what, I've been texting Dirty Daddy all night. I know that he's got IWTV fired up on the phone. I know he's got an iOS. He gives me shit all the time because I got an Android. But nobody is watching this match more closely than Chris Dickinson, who wanted to come here tonight at the White Eagle and finish business.